carried out to the editorial mechanism of the RHK. And we would like to take this opportunity to thank members for the support of the work of the panel. Thank you.
Dr. Lo Wai-kwok will address the Council on the report of the Panel on Development 2020-21. Dr. Lo Wai-kwok, President, as Chairman of the Panel on Development, I hereby submit the work report of the panel for the current legislative session, and I will highlight our key areas of work. In this session, the panel continued to monitor the work of the government in increasing land supply. Members supported the funding proposals for North New Territories development and Tongchong New Town extension, and urged the administration to speed up the development of related transport infrastructure to dovetail with the new population intake. The panel also made visits to reclamation sites at NT North and Tongchong East to learn about these developments. On the project to relocate Sha Tin sewage treatment works to Kevins, the panel noted that the project can vacate 28 hectares of land for other developments and raise views and concerns over the implementation arrangements and cost control. Members also discussed a number of establishment proposals relating to land and district development, including the implementation of development and conservation projects related to Lantau and the Invigorating Island South Initiative. In terms of enhancing building rehabilitation, the panel welcomed the launch of the new $1 billion building drainage system repair subsidy scheme by the government to address concerns from the public over health risks caused by substandard drains in buildings in light of the pandemic. Members were also briefed on the Urban Renewal Authority's latest work in terms of redevelopment, including the district study for Yamate and Mongkok and the relevant outcome and recommendations. Members urged the administration to provide suitable incentives to encourage developers to take part in urban renewal projects in order to speed up the pace of redevelopment. In the current session, the panel also considered a number of funding proposals relating to water and drainage works, and the panel noted that Hong Kong has signed a new supply agreement for Dongjiang water from 2021 to 2023 with the Guangdong province. The new agreement provides for an annual supply ceiling, and the current package deal lump sum approach would be refined to become the package deal deductible sum approach to deduct the water price based on the actual amount of water supplied. The panel also continued to monitor the government's work in conserving and revitalizing heritage sites and buildings in Hong Kong. Members expressed support at the funding proposals at the three Batch 5 projects under the Revitalizing Historic Buildings through Partnership Scheme, that is Roberts Block, Old Victoria Barracks, Lun Wah Market, and former Lau Fau Shan Police Station. In terms of legislative proposal, the panel considered a proposed members' bill to amend the Protection of the Harbour Ordinance. The other areas of work of the panel were listed on the report. Thank you.
Mr. Frankie Yik will address the Council on the report of